All right. So last time I updated, I was coming back from Germany, and basically things have changed in the last week. And as somebody trying to pursue football, apparently this is just how it goes. So I got the opportunity to go trial with a Irish Premier League team, and I just couldn't say no to the opportunity. They had already like vetted me and everything, so I kind of just need to go in and perform, and they're like in season right now. So yeah, if I do well, there's no reason I can't sign and start playing right away. And it would be like my first contract. So I'm pretty excited. My whole plans in Germany have been a bit upheavaled, but that's kind of how it goes. So I'm taking it day by day, going with the flow per usual. But I'm really excited. So I talked to the coaches, 2 days ago, and they've kind of got the whole plan going. So I'm pretty excited, but I know that it's going to be hard playing straight off jet lag. But I'm going to obviously bring you guys along with me and try to document the whole thing, because I think that this is going to be an opportunity that really like go somewhere. They're losing girls to England, as in like the girls have performed well and now they're getting picked up by teams in England, so hopefully that will be me in the future. My goal's always been to play in England, so that's what I'm hoping for, and I'm pretty excited. I've never been to Ireland, so another country down. Yeah, this will be the fourth country I would have played soccer in, so actually fifth, that's a lot. But there's the update for now. I'm about to leave for the airport. I'm gonna grab a bagel on the way, because it's the last time I'll get a good bagel. You know, I have no idea what Irish food looks like. I don't know if I wanna know, but I'm just kidding. I think it'll be good. I will see you guys later at the airport. But yeah, we're just gonna take it day by day. So as a footballer, you gotta be ready to be on the move. So when the opportunity presents itself, you gotta roll with it. So that's what we're doing. Toronto, and I'm out of breath because I just carried this thing up like four flights of stairs. Anyways, so I have one flight left and
I'll be in Dublin, so a little bit of a layover. I'll probably grab some food and watch some of the Euros, so. I'm on my way to baggage claim, and then the coach is gonna meet me at the exit, so. So I've made it. I've just been getting a tour around the city right now, and it's honestly such a cute little city in the middle of Ireland, but he's showing me the training grounds and everything, and then I'll go to the house later where I'll be staying, and this will be the house also if I sign that I'd be living in, so. Just crazy, just got off the plane and then like, yep, just full swing, so I'm tired, but we'll see. I could do a session later today, he said, with the assistant coach. I don't know if that would hurt or help me for tomorrow, so that's what I'm trying to decide. Alright guys, I just got into the house, so here is the little Irish house that I'll be staying in for the week and permanently if I've signed, so. So you walk in, there we go. This is the little sitting room, you know? It's pretty like basic. You got your kitchen over here. Yep. Here's the upstairs. Bathroom. And here's my room. Okay, I know I was a bad vlogger yesterday. I didn't really video training because I just wanted to be respectful. Basically just did that, got some food, bought a towel, and then watched the Euros and the Italy and Croatia game. It was crazy. But anyways, today is game day. So we're doing the scrimmage at like 7, so I'll be picked up at like 3:30 or something. It's by Dublin, which is like an hour away. So I just put on some regular clothes. I want to go into town, go for a walk, and get some breakfast. So honestly, the jet lag wasn't that bad. I was able to sleep like 7-8 hours, so that was good. Needed that. And yeah, I'm gonna go explore. The weather's not as nice right now. Okay, we're gonna go get some breakfast because I'm hungry. So, and then I'm gonna come back and chill probably. Rest as much as I can. Yeah, but I'm excited. We play Shelburne, so they're like good as well. I'm excited though. So I'll take you guys with me. Absolutely just caressed for a nap right now. Like, hour and a half, I was out. And for me, that's really long. So, like dead, no energy. I need to wake up. All right, since it's almost time to go, I've just been stretching and kind of getting ready, but I figured I'd just kind of share my thoughts before, but yeah, I'm definitely excited. I'm gonna try to focus on being aggressive, attacking, and playing simple when needed, but definitely making runs,
and just kind of playing differently than I have in the six, because it's a completely different kind of position. But I think I'm gonna be box to box, so definitely just gonna try to bring energy. And I feel good. I took like an hour and a half nap, which never happens to me. I can only usually sleep for like 20 minutes at a time. So I was definitely tired, but I grabbed some food and yeah, I'm feeling excited. So that's the main thing. And I'm gonna be picked up here soon. And I'm pretty sure the coach said I'll play like 70 minutes for sure. 90 if I feel up to it. So I'm excited though. I think it's just gonna be fun. And it's my first game in Ireland. So here we go. I don't know how much I'll film of being there, but regardless, this is kind of the experience. I mean, been waiting today for it, so.
I did say, I said Tregan earlier, I'm not gonna lie.
That's okay.
When somebody-
there you go.
You can pronounce this two ways.
Kale.
Kale. Think about the end of it.
I don't know what sound that makes in Celtic.
Maybe it's Irish, it's more Celtic. That's
like a, what is it?
Kiva.
It's not in Ireland.
Cole.
Kiva. In the north
they
say Kiva.
Kiva.
But...
she's made me pronounce Irish
names. Oh
shit,
it's backwards.
A-O-R-I-F-E.
Oif.
Oif. Oif.
No.
What is it?
Can I?
Okay. We're gonna compare words, so I'll say what I would say. Rich.
Loaded.
Minted.
Minted. Ah, okay, that's what it says. A diaper?
Nappy.
Alright. Band-aid?
Plaster.
What?
Well, you didn't say that at all. I feel like that's so weird.
Okay. A sweater.
Jumper.
Yeah. Okay, to make fun of someone.
Slagman.
Yeah, that was crazy. I was talking to...
oh, yeah, we were talking about it, and she goes, oh, that sounds dirty, and then she was like, oh, because...
yeah, because in... Sounds like shag, and then slag is like a slug.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, which is just terrible. Trash bag.
Bin bag.
Okay.
Are these all right? Am I getting these?
You're hitting it. She like spilled the tea. What would y'all say?
I say something. Gossip.
Spill the tea with gossip.
Gossip. Okay, you say some now, and I'll try to see.
Oh yeah.
What are
or like, what's the sauce?
Yeah.
We'd say what's the sauce.
That's crazy.
Going?
Yeah.
Okay, wait. What's
Do you guys say lore?
Lore.
Lore. Like, tell me the lore.
Oh no, absolutely.
So like, with
we
your
say
situation.
Tell me the
gossip.
Yeah,
okay.
Tell me the
gossip.
This is like a college US thing.
The lore.
The lore.
It's
so
weird,
it's like. You know, like the folklore, like the story. So
oh.
Tell me the story.
Okay.
Tell
no,
me the lore.
No, never need up.
Yeah. Say like, this place is really facey. Like, if you go somewhere and you know a bunch of people, it's facey.
Oh.
Yeah.
So like, it's active.
Yeah.
We take
it's just like it's you know a lot of people. Yeah.
We just
yeah.
say we just say a busy place is active.
Ah, okay.
But if this was like. There's like toys it's active and then the stories is like active because like
yeah.
everyone you know.
It's just the way
you
that's fair.
So
we'd say gaff for a house.
Like
yeah, what is
gaff.
A gaffer?
Oh,
gaffer's like a manager.
Yeah.
Like I walked in today and I was like, what's up, gaffer?
Yeah.
John? That's
yeah.
just like boss.
I thought it was like a I didn't know what I thought it was when it was like.
But then we'd say like someone's gaff is their house, so
okay.
Like oh they've got a nice gaff.
Yeah.
Sorry. We would say like you can say crib.
We wouldn't say crib.
We would,
right.
But I've never used that in my actual life, so.
Yeah, but it's okay.
No.
Well, it's like
unless you're joking, you're like, welcome to my crib, and you're like, MTV, yeah.
Fair.
MTV, welcome to my crib.
Simple 1v1, yeah? You play into Ellen, Ellen bounces back to you, and attack her. Good, Alyssa. Good. Love that. Good step over. Love that.
Alright guys, so yeah, I had just like a small session today with like three other players, and I think I'll either show that before or after I talk about this, but it was good. Did some 1v1s. I'm not gonna lie, I'm really tired, but honestly I really like the girls on the team. It's a really good environment, very professional. They have trackers and all that stuff, so, you know, I have to get a bit more game fit, they said, which is fair. I mean, I didn't realize how, like, back and forth it is here. Like, I'm fit, but not, you know, they want somebody to come in 90 minutes and be week in, week out. So, that being said, you know, I have the spot and the opportunity, so it's up to me to make the most out of that, and I have no doubt I'll be game fit playing all the time. So if that's all it's about, then you know it's up to me to get there. That's just purely effort, so I'm really excited, and you know, call my parents, and you know, this is gonna be kind of like the first contract, so it's not all set in stone. I've got to talk to the director tomorrow, but he told my agent, you know, to kind of let me know so that I don't have this hanging over my head going into training tomorrow of not knowing like where they're at. But they definitely saw enough and are excited. I'm excited. This is exactly what I've been waiting for, this kind of opportunity. So it's been a long road coming, but still need to perform well tomorrow. I'll either talk to the director before or after practice. It was very much worth the risk. I'm super excited, but I'm gonna stretch now and be ready for tomorrow. So.
Hey, for Wexford, number 18, Angelina, we play 5, number 33, Alex.